like 7 months. Yes, I know, because I filmed the Tanzania video and then I went MIA on you guys. I am so sorry about that. From the title of this video, you would have seen that this is a life update, an unplanned pregnancy, COVID-19, cancelled vacation trips. So much has happened. I just thought that before I bombard you guys with content on so many things that have been happening, it's only right that I film a life update. If I can't talk in this video, please bear with me, okay? I've not sat down to film a video in a while. But jumping straight into it, I'm good. I just had a major surgery, but I'm fine. I'm recovering. My husband is good. He's well, thank God. My family is well. We have an addition. I will get to that later on. But yeah, okay. I am okay. After my last video, while filming that video, I didn't even know I was expecting. So yeah, I was pregnant. And it was an unplanned pregnancy. Just to state, in case you misunderstand me, an unplanned pregnancy doesn't mean an unloved baby or an unloved pregnancy. It wasn't just planned. That's it. So yeah, I found out later on I was expecting. I don't really do well with pregnancies. I have I throw up a lot. I get really sick first, second, even up to third trimester. Hemoglobin is low, iron deficiency. So much goes on when I'm pregnant. So I've been dealing with all that. To crown the entire thing, the COVID-19 situation escalated as well. My word. 2020 was that year for me. If you didn't know, Tanzania was my first travel destination because it was somehow impromptu. I wanted to go to a destination that doesn't require me to do a visa. Since I have a Cameroonian passport, I could just get there, pay $50 for myself and my daughter, and that was it. I could have gone to Singapore as well, but I was afraid of going to Asia because the COVID over there was already really bad. By Feb, I think I went in February. I went to Tanzania in February. I would have gone to Singapore, but I couldn't because of COVID. So I went to Africa instead. But yeah, after Tanzania, my next vacation was supposed to be in April for my daughter's birthday. We were thinking either to do Bali or Maldives. That couldn't happen. The next vacation was supposed to be my birthday in June, where I would have probably gone away just with Dolly because my husband was not chance. I was looking at maybe Thailand, like that. It couldn't happen. Next vacation was supposed to be my wedding anniversary. It couldn't happen. My husband's birthday, it couldn't happen. COVID affected me personally, affected me a whole lot because, like I said, 2020 was that year for me where I intended to do a lot of traveling, bring a lot of traveling content to you guys, but that couldn't happen. Also, the COVID as well, I don't know about other countries. In the comment section, let me know how COVID affected you in person, if it affected your finances, if you even got sick, if you had COVID. I have had to do the COVID test. I don't want to talk about it right now. But my results were negative. Thank God. I don't know anybody in person that has been tested positive so far. But let me know in the comment section how COVID has affected you personally. For me, the most part it affected my job. I had to work from home. I've been working from home. Right now I'm not working because I have a baby. I had to work from home since March. That means spending more time with the fam bam, but of course that means my work also got affected, the distraction from Talia and all of that. Yeah, and also the lockdown. At some point Dubai was under lockdown, like nobody leaves, nobody comes in, malls were shut down. Like just the mental aspect of it, you stay locked up in your house for a month or so, you can't go anywhere. Even if you're going somewhere, you wear the mask, which by the way, wearing mask in pregnancy is no joke, it's no fun, it suffocates me. Sometimes I felt like I couldn't breathe. So COVID, personally, I didn't get tested positive, but it affected my job. My company made a lot of people redundant, by the way. A lot of companies in Dubai, so many people are jobless around the world. It's not only Dubai, everywhere around the world. Of course, salary reductions, so finances were affected. My company as well. So salaries were affected, like really badly, really really badly. So yeah, that's it. That's like the life update I wanted to talk about. So if you want to know, like more about Dubai, things have calmed down. Tourists can come in. I can travel if I want to, but I just don't want to go through the stress of having to do a COVID test prior to traveling, arriving destination to a COVID test. Before I come back, I do another COVID test. When I arrive here, depending on the country I'm from, I probably do again another COVID test. Like, it's just a lot. Talia won't have to do it, but it, because for most countries, children under 12 don't have to necessarily do the test. But as an adult, the one time I did the COVID test, I thought that woman was tweaking my brain. Like, I thought she, Jesus, hell no. No, no, if it involves me doing a COVID-19 test, count me out. Honestly, just count me out. Yeah. That's it. That's the life update I wanted to talk to you guys about. Again, like I said, I'm well. I'm thriving. I'm okay. I have so much content to bring to you guys, which I will, by the way. But that's it. I can see we are almost at 5,000 subs. Please, if you have not subscribed to my channel, click that subscribe button. Click the like button as well if you've enjoyed this video. I hope to catch you guys in the next one.